for me and show me like you're angry and relax your muscles? So I'm going to place Botox in the center between your eyes and these two muscles, which are called the corrugator muscles. These muscles pull together and down, causing that frown muscle. So if we prevent that with Botox, then your eyebrows are going to separate and lift, taking away this deep furrow. So frown for me again and relax your face. Again, it really shouldn't hurt, just a little pinch. Great, how was that?
Great.
And frown for me again, because if we place this, relax your face, the muscle contracts the most, it's going to be more effective for you. So we say the point of maximum contraction is where we want to hit that Botox. Scrunch for me again. Perfect. And relax. 1, 2, 3, a little pinch. Excellent. So Botox will start to take effect in a couple of days, maximum effect in a week. It should be absolutely perfect. Anything less than that is really not acceptable.
It doesn't hurt at all.
Close your eyes really tight. This lateral muscle of the brow pulls down. Relax your face. Little pinch. Sometimes that one's a little bit more sensitive. And that gives us that lateral lift of the eyebrow. Close your eyes really tight. See how that pulls down? And relax your face. Well done. And the great thing about Botox, as you can see, she doesn't have any marks or spots left behind. She can head right back to work or right back to her normal activities. Raise your eyebrows now. So these are the elevator muscles, and you have to be careful not to over-relax these because it can cause the brow to fall. Relax your face. Little pinch. If we over-treat the forehead area, that's where people can look like a mannequin. And that's really not acceptable, unless somebody wants to look like that. Great. Now, in this area, since the forehead muscle is thin and much broader than these cords or these corrugators, it takes a few days longer to diffuse through that thin muscle. But I like it to look absolutely natural. Okay, Anne, can you open your eyes? Great.